I have a running instance in Amazon where I can log into this machine and I'm going to do the installation of Spark. Let me copy the public DNS. I have already saved that as a session. Let me just verify the IP address is same. Yes, it is. And I'm going to use the user ID EC2-user and the key with which I have started this particular instance I have selected. Now I'm going to save open. I'll be into this particular machine. For Spark to work, you need Java. As well as in case if you are going to use Python API, you need the Python installation. By default, many Linux systems, they come with Python. We need to make sure we have the Java JDK installed. I'm going to install the Java JDK. Install. I need to provide sudo because the installation can be done only with a super user. Java 1.8.0-openjdk. This will install the Java JDK 1.8. And Spark can be downloaded from this specific location. I can go ahead with the version 2.3.1. So whichever the version that I want, I can select. And it is pre-built with Hadoop. Whatever the version we want, we can choose. And I'll be selecting this particular zip file. And let me copy this specific location. And let me get that zip file. You see, wget. So this will download the zip file and I need to unzip it. That will be considered as the Spark installation is done. I'll show a couple of steps how to verify the Spark installation. The Spark download is done. I need to unzip. Say tar cf. Get extracted in the same location, and this is the home directory. I'm going to just rename this particular folder as a simple folder name. Let me see more. Well, so within Spark folder, I should have bin, yes, bin, and all the required jar files, configurations, all that should be available. So within bin folder, we have some executables like Spark SQL, Spark Shell, Pyspark, all that available. And within sbin, we have commands to start various processes like worker, master, all that available. We'll be seeing all these commands in detail later point of time. Now let us start a sample shell to try out whether the installation went through fine or not. If yes, I can start a number of such instances and start a cluster as well. So within bin folder, there is a command called spark shell. We can start that /bin/spark shell. Spark shell is nothing but an application that's going to open an interactive shell where we can provide the commands that we wanted to execute. And that will provide a spark context. Every application will have a Spark context and that will provide a web UI as well that's going to run in port 4040 where I can access it through the public IP address where it will give the statistical information on what all jobs got submitted to this particular application, that is Spark shell. I can start a Python shell as well by giving the command pyspark. Let's do a small example, a very simple example, say val. For the time being, don't worry what is this text file, what I am doing with this val, what is count, don't worry about it. It's going to count how many lines we have within this specific file. I'm getting some output. And I'll be in a position to see one job got submitted and that got executed. Let's not worry about the statistical information provided over here. We will see these all in detail later. So this shows the Spark installation went through fine without any issue, and it is good enough for us to work with this particular installation. The same way, I can start Python shell as well. To come out of the scalar shell, colon Q will take me out of the scalar shell. The same way, I can get into the Python shell as well. /bin/pyspark. This will open up the Python shell and it will provide me the Spark context to work with. The shell gives us a confirmation the installation went through fine.